हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू पोएम नंबर 6, नो मेन आर फॉरेन, रिटन बाय जेम्स कर्कअप. नाउ, हैव यू एवर थॉट ऑफ सम पीपल एज स्ट्रेंज और अदर कंट्रीज एज फॉरेन? वी हैव मेनी वेज ऑफ थिंकिंग ऑफ अदर पीपल एज बीइंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अस एंड एज देम. दे मे बिलोंग टू अ डिफरेंट कंट्री और स्पीक अ डिफरेंट लैंग्वेज. इन दिस पोएम, हाउएवर, the poet reminds us of the many ways in which we are all the same, for we are all human. So this title, No Men Are Foreign, means that no men belong to another country. The poet wants to say that all men are the same, all men are equal. He wants to promote the concept of universal brotherhood. So in this poem, the poet wants to tell us that everyone in this world is the same. All people, all men are the same. They eat, they live, they die the same way. Everyone gets the bounties of nature, like sunshine, land, in equal measure. We can also say that it's a peace poem. So, before we begin the poem explanation, let us learn something more about James Kirkup. James Falconer Kirkup, born James Harold Kirkup, was an English poet, translator and travel writer. He wrote over 30 books, including autobiographies, novels and plays. And some of his works are The Haiku, 100, Burning Giraffes and more. So now let us go to the poem, No Men Are Foreign by James Kirkup. Remember, no men are strange. No country is foreign. Beneath all uniforms, a single body breathes. Like ours, the land our brothers walk upon is earth like this, in which we shall all lie. Now, the meaning of the words beneath means underneath, and strange is unknown. Now, in the first line, the poet says that no men are strange and no country is foreign. So, why does he say this? He is attempting to remove the borders from the earth which have been erected in order to separate different countries. Then, only then, no country will be foreign. We will feel that every country is our own land and there will be no borders. Everyone will be free to move around. The poet wants to say that the entire earth is one, and all people who live on this earth belong to the human race. Then he says that inside, underneath the uniforms worn by soldiers of different countries, the human being is the same. God has made all of them in a similar way, in a similar mold, all breathe the same way. Then he says that all soldiers are our brothers. We all walk upon the same Mother Earth, and after our death, we all lie in the grave in the same earth. Now let us go on to the next stanza. Stanza 2. They too, aware of sun and air and water, are fed by peaceful harvests, by war's long winter starved. Their hands are ours, and in their lines we read a labor not different from our own. Now, they refers to the people who belong to other countries. We call them foreigners and discriminate against them and fight with them. The poet says that nature has given all the wonderful blessings, her bounties to people, also just like she has given to us. Everyone gets sunlight, air and water in equal measure, which means that God does not differentiate between people from all different countries. We carry out farming during the times of peace, and when there is no war, we lived a very relaxed life and eat the things given to us by nature. Further, he adds that the way we starve during wars and winter time is also the same for people belonging to other countries. Then he wants to say that foreigners who belong to another country and we all are the same. And then the poet says that even their hands are the same as ours. They work very hard, they labor just like we do. He is giving all these examples to to convey to the reader that there is no difference in us and all people belonging to another country. Now, let us go on to stanza 3. Remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep, and strength that can be won by love in every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. The poet asks the reader to remember something. He says, we should keep in mind that the people of another country whom we consider as our enemies have been given by God with similar appearance like us. God has given them eyes like ours, which open when awake and close when we are asleep. Similarly, he has given them strength which we can win through love. Then he says that in every country, in every land, there is one common thing. What is that? That is life. Life means all the things that we have while we are living. And if we can recognize them, and if we can understand their feelings and realize that they are similar, they are just like us, then that understanding will cause peace to prevail. That understanding will erase wars or fights between us. Then, let us remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall dispossess, betray, condemn. Remember, we who take arms against each other. So now in this verse, the word dispossess means to dislodge or to deprive. What does the poet mean in this poem? The poet says, we must remember that whoever tells someone, when someone tells us to hate other people, to hate a person from another country, to think of him as our enemy, and whenever we think someone to be our enemy, then we are depriving ourselves, we are cheating ourselves, and lastly, we are condemning ourselves. He says that we should stay away from such negativity. We must not consider anyone to be our enemy. For during a war, both parties must bear losses. And that's the reason why the poet says that war is not in our favor. He says that whenever we pick any weapon against anyone, we must remember one thing. Now, let us go on to verse 5, stanza 5. It is the human earth that we defile. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. Remember, no men are foreign and no country strange. Now, the word defile means to make dirty or pollute, and outrage the innocence of means to violate the purity of. So, in the last verse, let us remember, what is the poet trying to say? We should keep in mind that whenever we pick weapons against any person, we make the earth dirty, because weapons kill people and their bodies which fall to the earth make it dirty. Whenever war happens, it leads to a lot of bloodshed, fire, death, suffering, misery and sorrow. These dead bodies accumulate, collect on the earth and make it impure. The fire of war which erupts, the smoke which comes out, the dust that fills the air, it is so dirty that it pollutes and outrages the purity of the air. With all these things, the poet wants to give us a message that we must not indulge in war. Finally, he ends the poem by writing the first line in reverse and saying that, remember, no men are foreign and no country is strange. That means everyone over this whole earth is our brother. And he wants to bring across, he wants this message to go across, that we are all brethren, we all belong to the same family of human beings, and God is our father, we are all brothers and sisters. So now let us have a look at the figures of speech in this poem. Let us go on to the first line. Remember, no men are strange and no countries foreign. This first line is litotes or litotes. The poet has used a negation to convey a positive meaning. Here, no men are foreign means all men belong to the same family of human beings and therefore we should not fight. It is also tautology. The poet has unnecessarily used the word strange and foreign to convey the same meaning, to be unknown. And there is also repetition of the word no for poetic effect. The second line, beneath all uniforms a single body breathes. This is, the word uniform suggests different types of garments. And this is synecdoche because the part body stands for all human beings. It is also alliteration. The sound of the consonant B is repeated in beneath body and breathes. Like ours, the land our brothers walk upon the earth is like this, in which we shall all lie. Now here we have euphemism. The unpleasant idea of death of a person is spoken through pleasant words like shall lie. They too are aware of sun and air and water. The word and is repeated for poetic effect. Are fed by peaceful harvest, by war's long winter story. This is antithesis. The opposite words peaceful and war are used in the same sentence for poetic effect. And the adjective peaceful has been transferred from people to harvests. Their hands are ours and in their lines we read. Synecdoche is the part hand stands for human beings of other countries. Then, there is inversion in the construction of the sentence for poetic effect. A labor not different from our own. This is Lycurgus. The poet has used a negation to convey a positive meaning. Remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep. This is antithesis. Opposite words wake and sleep are used for poetic effect. And eyes is synecdoche as it stands for people. And strength that can be won by love. Now, this is an overstatement that love can win strength. In every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. This is tautology. Unnecessary use of words recognize and understand that have the same meaning. Let us remember whenever we are told to hate our brothers. Now, this is internal rhyming. Words are R-A-R-E. And O-U-R for poetic effect. It is ourselves that we shall dispossess, betray and condemn. This is tautology. The poet uses unnecessarily three words, dispossess, betray and condemn, all which convey the same meaning to hate. Remember, we who take arms against each other. The word to take arms against means to fight. It is the human earth that we defile. Inanimate earth is given the animate quality of being human. And then, hells of fire and dust outrage the innocents. Metaphor. There's an indirect comparison between fire and dust and human passion and hate. Then the last line is, of air that is everywhere our own. Hyperbole. There is an overstatement of the fact that the air is our own. It belongs to us. Now let us go on to the question answers of this lesson. First one, think about the poem and answer the questions given below. Beneath all uniforms, what uniforms do you think the poet is speaking about? Well, human beings wear different clothes all over the world, and you will know that very well when you look at India. People have different clothes that they wear, and according to their gender, age, community, climate, profession. But beneath all those uniforms, everyone has a similar type of body that breathes and lives. Then, how does the poet suggest that all people are the same? Well, the poet James Kirkup suggests that all people on the earth are the same. They all breathe air, they are buried inside the same earth. They wake up, they sleep, they hate, they love, and they work very hard in order to earn money. All of them need the sun, air and water. That means their necessities are the same. All enjoy peace and good harvests, and they all suffer due to poor harvests and violence due to wars. Now in stanza 1, find 5 ways in which we are all alike. Pick out the words. Each of us has a similar body. All of us breathe. All of us walk on similar land. We live and die on the same Mother Earth. All of us will be buried on our ashes, will merge with the earth. How many common features can you find in stanza 2? Pick them out. There are 5 common features: the sun, the air, the water, the peaceful harvest, wars, working with our hands, fortune lines in each one's hands. Whenever we are told to hate our brothers, when do you think this happens? Why? Who tells us? And what does the poet say? Whenever there is war and unrest, some selfish people make people hate each other. They are hate mongers. They do so for selfish reasons and personal benefits. They cause violence and innocent people get killed. We should not blindly follow such people. We are children of the same Creator. So in a way, we are not strangers and enemies, but brothers and sisters. If we fight with the people, then we should understand that we actually hate our own brothers. So, now, what has Socrates said? I am a citizen, not of Athens or Greece, but of the world. And this is true for all of us. So let us all believe in universal brotherhood and do all we can to promote harmony with people around us. Thank you, children, and have a nice day.